Hey everyone, today we're going to be learning about the proportional editing tool inside a Blender, which will help us when we're editing our objects while modeling. To get started, I'm going to add a cube so we can showcase this tool. So I'll press Shift and then A to open the Add menu. Then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube. Then I'm going to press Tab to go into Edit mode and press A to select everything. Then I'm going to right click and then left click Subdivide. You can see this has created some more faces on my cube for us to edit, and a little menu called Subdivide will appear in the bottom left hand corner, which I can just left click to open. And here I can increase my number of cuts. I'm just going to go for something like 8, and you can see that's added a lot more faces. To turn on the proportional editing tool, we can come to the top here, and right beside this little curve symbol, you can see there's a little circle within a circle. This is the proportional editing tool, and you just left click it to turn it on, and you can see it will go blue when it's enabled. You can also press the O key on the computer to toggle it on and off. If I left click this curve button beside it, this is all the settings for the proportional editing. You can see here we have something called proportional size, which I'm going to demonstrate in a minute. I'm going to press 1 on the keyboard, which is going to take us into vertex select, and I'm going to scroll in and left click one of my vertices. Right now, you can see we have our proportional editing enabled because it's blue, and I'm just going to press G and then Z to pull up this vertex on the Z axis, and you can notice how the vertices around it are going to get pulled up as well because of this proportional editing tool. Once you left click to save your edit, if you open up the Move panel here, you can see that the box for proportional editing is checked. So if you made an edit and decided you didn't want to use proportional editing for that edit, you can turn it off here after. Notice how this is how it would have looked if we hadn't used proportional editing. I'm going to left click turn it back on, and now we can see more of our proportional editing settings. The proportional size here is the same as the one we had as this menu here, and it will apply to this specific edit we've made. So I can adjust this so I can make it bigger or smaller. So notice as I decrease this, it's going to get more like nothing happened at all as we reach zero. Then as we increase it, more and more is going to get affected until eventually the whole cube will be affected. I'll turn it back to the default, which is 1. Here we also have a setting called proportional falloff, and this is the curve options which we can choose here in the menu. I'm going to demonstrate a few of these. Smooth is the default. We also have sphere. We have root, which you can see is going to create almost like a pointed sphere. We also have sharp, which is going to create more of like a mountain peak effect. We have linear, constant, and random, which could be good if you wanted to pull out some random terrain perhaps. I'll put it back to smooth for now. I'm going to left click a vertex here, and I'm going to press G and Y to put it along the Y axis. And something you can do as well is while I'm moving with proportional editing, I can scroll my mouse wheel to increase that effect size again, which may be a lot more intuitive than editing it after positioning it. So I'll just left click to position it there, and you can notice my proportional size was reduced with the scroll wheel. Next up, I'm going to open up my menu here, and this time I'm going to choose projected from view. Then I'm going to left click one of my vertices on this plane of the face here, and I'm going to left click this green Y symbol here to go into the side view. And now I've got this projected from view on, and I press G and then X and pull out. You can see it's going to pull everything out along that plane. So it's almost being projected, and you can see in the move box it says projected 2D because you're essentially projecting it across the kind of viewing axis. And also if you do it without flattening your view, and I press G and Y, you can notice we can get some kind of interesting effects as well. So this projected option can be quite useful in some cases. Next up we have connected only. I'm going to turn off my projected from view and turn on my connected only. And this time I'm going to left click one of my vertices. And when I press G and X, you're going to notice no immediate difference. And that's because this connected only really applies when you have multiple separated collections of polygons within your one object. So I'll press Shift A, and then I'm going to choose cube, and this is going to add a cube inside of my object in edit mode. So this won't be creating a brand new object, but it's more like an extension of the object we're editing. And then I'm going to press G and X to move this along. Now you'll notice if I left click one of my vertices, press G and X to move it, that is not going to affect this cube beside it, even though these are the same object. However, if I left click this button here and then turn off connected only and press G and X, and then increase my radius, your notice is going to start influencing the cube beside it as well. And you'll notice when I finish here and turn on connected again, it's not going to affect our cube beside it anymore. And that just about covers the proportional editing tool inside a Blender. This video was part of my Blender Modeling for Absolute Beginners series, which I'm making on YouTube at the moment. So if you do want to see more tutorials like this, feel free to check out the playlist here, which I'm currently adding a lot of videos to it. I upload videos about twice a day, so you can expect to see more tutorials like this very shortly. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.